If you're planning trips abroad this summer, you want to take note of ways to keep your gut health in check, because a digestive system in turmoil means a vacation is ruined. I've been there. Dr. John Ziebrt with Austin Gastroenterology is here with more. And I guess, first of all, what is the risk or some of the risks when we travel abroad that can deal with our gut?
Well, one of the major risks is developing the classic turista or travel-related diarrhea. And that typically occurs when you go to resource-rich areas like the United States to areas that have more limited resources. Yeah. So you have to be careful in those countries. And although the illness is usually, you know, self-limited, meaning you get over it on your own, you can become quite sick, and it can really damper your vacation plans.
It can totally ruin it, for sure. So what are ways we can prevent?
Well,
on the front end.
Food and water precautions are probably the most important thing you can do. So you want to avoid certain types of foods. You want to avoid the street vendors. You want to eat hot foods. You want to avoid tap water, even tap water for brushing your teeth. Freezing does not kill the bacteria that cause these illnesses, so ice should be avoided. Mm-hmm. And the worst news you can have is that alcohol doesn't sterilize the ice or the water, so mixed drinks are a problem too.
Yeah, so you have to be really careful about where you are, and maybe you're at a certain resort that might be a little cleaner or more well-equipped. You know, just use common sense.
Right, you have to use judgment, and you know, you have to kind of interrogate what the resort is like and see what their history is.
What about like taking along hand sanitizer or bleach wipes? Should we kind of have those?
That would be very helpful as well, because these bacteria are spread by food and water, so you need to make sure your hands are clean when you're touching things.
So what if we do fall ill on our trip? How do we know when it's time to see a doctor?
That's a great question, because when you're in a foreign country, you often don't know where to go. So the kind of the alarm features you would have would be high fevers, severe abdominal pain, symptoms that are lasting more than 7 days, or if you develop bloody diarrhea, those would all be indications for seeing a doctor.
Yeah. What's the typical run of time, though, for this, if we get a little bug like this?
Right. Typically, it lasts about 3 to 5 days.
That's like as long as your trip. That stinks.
Right.
So you just came back from a trip not too long ago, but you were careful with what you ate and drank. And I was saying, I always get like chips and guacamole. You said that's probably not a good idea. Like salsa can be shady too, you know?
Right. You have to be careful about types of foods that are left on a table, you know, like the salsas and things like that. You don't know what how old that type of food is and what their conditions are in the kitchen, so you have to be careful.
So what would the doctor order? Like, what did you order?
I ordered a lot of hot meals.
Okay.
I didn't have a lot of, I didn't have any of the non-bottled waters.
Okay.
I avoided that.
Okay.
I avoided the ice. So beer is perfectly safe for you.
I love it. That's awesome. Well, I'm glad you had a great trip, and you've helped us to plan a good one, too.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, doctor. We appreciate it. Austin Gastroenterology has 18 clinic locations and 2 endoscopy centers in the greater Austin area. Go to schedule an appointment, and for more information, you can just head over to austingastro.com.